It's sunshine and flowers, it's almost a perfect day. I just need your smile to light my way. Can you come out to play? Hi, Refli from the Netherlands here with the second easy watercoloring art journal page. What you will need is a Strathmore visual journal, or of course any watercolor journal you would love to work in. I just love Strathmore. You need stencils, anything you like. I've used bubbles this time. You need a paintbrush for your watercolors, a palette knife, aquarelle pencil. You need a black pen and a white marker, Stazon ink and stamps. And of course some modeling paste, white cardstock, and of course my favorite watercolors from Winsor & Newton, and a glass of water. Of course you can use any products you have on hand or you like to work with. Now let's get started. So let's grab your favorite set of watercolors and add as much water and color as you like. For this background, I've used all the colors I love the most, and usually that are the rainbow colors or any color of the color wheel, probably. When you use watercolor as a background, don't be afraid to mess up. As you can see here, I'm adding water, I'm adding colors, and I want the colors to run into one another. I love the effect it gives. I love that it has a mind of its own. And just add water, add more watercolor, add water, add more watercolor. And that's exactly how I build up the background of this page. So don't be afraid to try out. See what works and what doesn't work. You will always have colors when they run into one another. They call it mud. Okay, it can be a little bit brown, but sometimes when it's dry, you've got the most beautiful combinations of colors. And sometimes when it's dry, you think, not that pretty. Then simply go over. Add more bright colors to the color you don't like. You can always go over. And if you use less water than the first time, it will be more vibrant and more colorful. Okay, so go on and create the background any way you like it. I'm just adding colors to this background, and I add some music under it now, so you can keep watching what colors I'm adding and just see what I'm doing. I want the sky to be blue, not black. Should be relaxed. I wanna look ahead, not back. Because this is the way it ought to be. This is the way it ought to be. This is the way it ought to be. It doesn't matter if I'm first or last. I'm gonna play the game and have a blast. 'Cause I'm the future. We are now going to add the modeling paste. The trick is, if you want the modeling paste to be colored the colors your watercolor are, use it when your watercolors are still wet. If you want the modeling paste to be white, as it is in this case, wait till your watercolors are dry. I love to mix everything up, so as you can see, my paint is still flowing, it's still wet. And I'm just adding the modeling paste. And when you are smearing with your palette knife, you can see already the modeling paste picking up the color of the watercolors. I love that effect. So don't be afraid to try out things that are not supposed to be like that. You have to supposed to be waiting till your paint is dry. Well, I'm not waiting. And sorry for my head. I keep forgetting my camera is above me, so sometimes you can see my hair. But I try to keep it out as much as possible. It wasn't working here very well, so forgive me. But as you can see, the modeling paste is picking up the color from the watercolors. That's just lovely. And try to mix it up. Try to get your modeling paste on different places on your art journal. And triangle is always a good idea. So you have to lay it apart to let it dry. Now we go on and write our title. I will stamp the title because it's a quote from Maya Angelou or Angelou, not sure how to pronounce it. And one word is going to be my title. And I'm writing it with a aquarelle pencil, a watercolor pencil actually. I'm just writing it by hand, and when I'm finished writing, I'm going to add clear water with it with a small brush. I just love the look of it because it doesn't look completely black. It's not like ink. You can still see it's kind of watercolor. Of course, you can use your watercolor to write with words or your brush pens. Choose whatever is best for you. I'm writing this on white cardstock, which I guess you can buy in any craft store. Maybe you still have some on hand. You can use any paper you like to do this. So I'm just writing the word, and after this I will add water with a small brush to it to make it look like watercolors. After you have finished writing your title, make sure it is dry and then cut it out. I love to cut it out with a little white border still around the word. So I have to get my small scissor for this, and I'm just cutting around the edges of the word I have just written, which I'm going to use as a title. So this might be very interesting to watch me cut this word, but I'll speed it up a little bit because we've got more to do. When you are finished cutting out your title, your word, you now need to cut some strips, which we are going to use to stamp the quote on. I just cut by hand, I don't measure it, I just eyeball it, and I cut a few strips, and we are going to stamp with Stazon ink and alphabet stamps on it. I'm going to stamp with Stazon ink and my little alphabet stamps. And as you can see, those are nice little rows of stamps because I've laid them down in the order of the alphabet. For me, that's the most effective and quick way to stamp. Otherwise, I'm constantly looking for letters. And later on, you will see I make a mistake. I had one of the letters turned sideways. But I just leave it in because I kind of like it and I like making mistakes and I like adding them to my art journal. So for this quote from Maya, I first figured out what words I want to write down in one sentence. So I'm stamping this on the strip and later on I'm cutting it in parts. But as you can see now, just like moons is going to be one strip. And now I'm going to add another sentence and I'm going to cut it here. There's the mistake. You see it? It's the D and it's lying sideways. And it's okay. It's totally okay. Just leave it in there. It's fun. We are only human people. So keep on stamping and I'll see you at the next part. When you are finished stamping, you can cut up your little strips of sentences. And then you are going to add black lines. And for that, I have used my Pilot Perma Ball, a rolling ball. I just love the look of it. And sometimes it doesn't get the ink where it needs to be. But I kind of love that too. It doesn't have to be too neat or too perfectionist. As you can see, sometimes I just miss ink. Sometimes I edit, sometimes I don't. So make tiny borders around your little sentences of your sentences. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it correctly, but I guess you know what I mean. Your little strips of words. And add borders around them and cut off the excess you don't need. Almost finished. Now you're just going to lay down your little strips of words And add your bigger word. For me, that was rice. And just eyeball it, look at it, look if it feels good to you. And then you can finish up the page by gluing it all down. I have used tacky glue, but I guess any glue which you will have on hand will do. Thank you so much for watching, creating me this cute and easy art journal page. I would love it if you would let me know what you think about it. And of course, if you like what you see, why don't you give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel? I mean, you have watched it till this far. Apparently, you like what I make. No, just kidding. If you like what I make, let me know. And if you have any ideas for other videos or things you would like me to try or make, shoot me an email, leave me a message, let me know. And maybe I just do it. Okay, bye.